Never an easy thing, you know? But yes, we return now with more of Metroid Prime 3. Now we need to find the acid shield unit. That's our main objective today. Last time, we took a little bit of a detour. We took a little bit of a detour to not only get our hands on the spider ball, but also unlock more areas that we can be able to use to explore this place. And believe me, there was a lot that we did. And if you think I kid, I don't. I'm not kidding because, sheesh, we were able to basically explore every nook and cranny this place has. But there's still a lot more that we need to do. So for now, we need to get back to our ship. And believe you me, we did a lot. But hey, I'm not the one to judge this when I'm trying to make sure I get this playthrough done on time. I only need to find 5 energy tanks, 2, the rest of the missiles. And unfortunately, I now gotta deal with this garbage, which I'm not interested in today. I am out. I got what I came for out of it, but anyway. Especially considering now that I have updated maps on Norian and Brio. We not only need to get the acid shield, which can help us explore, but also another weapon that can help us pierce through phasite. Yeah, I'm spoiling it, the Nova Beam. But this will also probably mean I have to return back to previous. I know there's one place here where I have to get that upgrade. Yeah. Anytime now. We will return back here later. Believe me, it's needed in order to find what's missing and clean it up for good. Time for us to head to the planet Homeworld and return to the research facility. I may also need to get new batteries for my Wiimote. Alright, prepare to make the jump to light speed. We're back here once more, but we're not leaving without the hazard suit. Right here is where we'll find it. It is good to hear from Admiral Dalton, by the way. Still, I can't...
Samus, the Federation Armada is now in orbit above the Pirate Homeworld. We're ready for the final assault, but the base is protected by a barrier that prevents us from landing. We need you to disable this defense system. Unit 242 has located its control center. Here are the coordinates.
Thanks. This might help us. Alright. So I now have two objectives. Objective one is to secure the hazard suit. Objective two is to take down the space pirates. And of course they decide to show up. Am I not surprised? Yup. Trapped within phase-eye. We can't pierce them without the Nova Beam. Oh, I always hated dealing with these phase-eye Metroids. You have to freeze them, then blast them. Yes, it's kind of stupid, I know. And I know that before the end of the game, we're gonna go through everything. Yes, we're cleaning up. Prime 2 didn't have that much of a cleanup to begin with. Gotta move fast. Get to that. Oh wait, we now have the spider ball. We can now do that. Let's move. Let's check each one to determine the best course of action. All right. Yep, now we're gonna have to experiment. All right, we've made it. With that over and done with, we get our hands on what we need. The hazard shield. Beautiful. This is the hazard shield. The suit is now capable of withstanding hazardous environments. You can also be able to move safely through acid rain and fuel gel. Yeah, looks like these guys were expecting this. Analysis. These are assault paratroopers. These guys are vulnerable to beam weapons. You like a crash landing, right? Oh yeah, we're supposed to activate something. There it is. They had to bring the alert, huh? Fine, let's take them all out. Do a little bit of an open heart surgery. Okay, I'm mad now. I'm promoted. There's still a matter of getting an item here, but I'm not leaving until we get it. There it is. This raises our missile count to 130. Alright. Now, with this finally obtained, let's get out of here. This is where we fought Gandreda. We will avenge her. Mark my words. Fair, I should have taken the other train. You know what? We may as well. Let's head back. I still can't believe it. And to be fair, Gandreda was my favorite boss fight in Metroid Prime 3. It was an intense one because it really tested your patience. At least now that we have the hazard shield in place, you could think of it as also pretty much the gravity suit for it. Or the Varia, because you only get like one suit upgrade and that's it. It takes us 2 missiles to wipe it out. Now we gotta do the same thing for the other one. So far, so good. I always thought. Analysis. This is a Metroid hatcher. When the head interior is damaged, its tentacles can be ripped off. Mutation has robbed the Metroid hatcher of its ability to phase, but has provided a hardened outer shell which has identical attributes to phaseite. It protects its heart, located at the core of its head. The hatcher's tentacles can be dangerous, and can leech energy from any targets. However, there are the creature's weakness. If all the tentacles are ripped from its body, it'll perish. As such, it will attempt to recover energy by retracting from the shell when they take damage. When they're retracted, it's unable to attack, relying on the phase-off Metroids. If the interior creature mouth is open, it'll lose its strength. Looks like we got a fight on our hands. Aha. Uh-huh.
coming from below. Yeah, if you aim below, it's tentacles.
Wow. Sorry about that earlier. My mom. Hey, I record when I can. I want to make sure I get it done. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, you keep spinning and spiraling out.
Doing this. You gotta be way back for it to work. Ow! Sure!
Good riddance to bad rubbish, I'd say. Now where is it? Oh. All that's done is for a platform. There you go. Now it raises our energy tank count from 9 to 10. Okay, so with that set, let's move. We only have 4 tanks left to get. Oh, nice. A save station. Save game. Let's continue. Alright, preparing for transport. All we have to do now is disable the defense shield.
Okay.
course.
Yeah, let's see them handle the acid rain now.
All right. That should disable the shield. They just had to put the security in place.
Yep, access gate's locked.
Damn! Fine! Let's go!
We're out of fight.
Guess we don't have a choice.
They're not gonna let us in through the front, huh?
Then we'll have to enter through another means. Gotta be another way to reach it. But if I have to, I will. Let's go. I think we might need to get our hands on a weapon that can help. Next stop, the mining site.
This journey ain't making it any easier, believe me. I only say this because, yeah, just as we're about to get closer,
they make things harder. Better for me personally. Good. Another save point. Now I can use it to recharge. And save my progress to be safe. That's gonna help me out. Although I can only follow the blue doors. I see. So now we can find a means to be able to get through. Let's shred this first. That is gonna definitely help us. Now let's take care of the other side. Now that we got that done, let's get to work. Let's get the goods. Now we're at 135. We still have a ways to go to getting everything in the game. For now, let us head this way. What's this? Yeah, hyper mode. No! Damn it! And suppose I don't make a mistake with doing that. It's a long way down. Sure is. If it means getting the Nova Beam, I have to. This is a Phazon Harvester drone, but overloading it will stun it, huh? Yeah, then. How many things does it need? I better move fast before that thing attacks. Jolly Roger drones! This beam sucks up and transports the loose Phazon cutting with a mine. And this? Mining cannon fires a high frequency beam. Well, this game is... Open and let me inside. So this is it. The Nova Beam. This is the one thing I need. So, what am I supposed to do? We need to find a power node. And it looks like someone beat us to it. They're not gonna let us have this thing without a fight, huh? He's entered hyper mode. there a way to beat these things?
Okay, now I'm starting to understand how this gimmick works. Oh my god. Oh my god. I had no idea. If you fall to that pit, you die. Oh wait, I saved beforehand, which means I gotta redo this garbage. Yep. Damn it. My first game over in like, what, 11 parts? At least later entries fix this stuff. This is ridiculous. Okay. I take it back. Their system's pretty decent. But... okay, you can actually skip this. Thank God for that, because I'm not going through that. Alright. Okay, so the piston extends. Okay. Okay.
So, how do I do this? Main cavern. Yeah, sorry.
It's because now I'm at this point and I can't even figure out what to do. Do I have to use more ball bombs or what?
There it is.
Jeez, it's not even telling me what I gotta do.
Four notes? I don't see any notes. I see.
Now I understand.
Get ready to get sucked in.
Better use these as cover.
Yeah, but he's not gonna be happy with it.
Is he?
good. Now to overload this damn thing.
Finally. I should have figured this all out sooner. You're supposed to leave one space pirate alive, so that way you can be able to, like, have an overload.
And thankfully, we now got our hands on it. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the Nova Beam.
And now we've got it, the Nova Beam. This Nova Beam is able to pass through objects made of phazite,
and that's gonna make exploration a lot better.
Good. Yeah, now we have one of the strongest weapons in the game, the Nova Beam.
And these unlock green doors. Now let's demonstrate its power.
And this gives us our missile expansion. We're at 140.
But these have another function.
Let's do a little bit of open heart surgery.
Yeah.
You can now kill Metroids in one shot. Because, holy moly, that's so useful. This makes them look like a joke. And also, we can now send the ship here.
Once we get things cleaned up, of course.
All right,
let's land the ship. Because our work's not finished yet.
Data received.
We still need to disable the shield. Now that we have what we need, we're set. But we're ending it here. Next time on Prime 3, we're gonna continue and hopefully allow the Federation to fight back. If you enjoyed this, like, comment, share, subscribe, and click the bell. I will see you in the next one. And let me tell you, it's not gonna be pretty. That is for sure. This is MegamanNG signing off. Peace out. We're in for the long haul.